Welcome to today's tutorial class, The Meaning of Evidence and Different Kinds of Evidence. Let me first share with you what is the meaning of the term evidence. The term evidence means a statement made before court on oath. It is generally called evidence. Thus, to call any statement as evidence, it must qualify two tests. Number one, it must be made before court on oath. And under our Evidence Act, we see different kinds of evidence. That is direct evidence and indirect evidence. The term direct evidence means evidence given by a person having perceived by his own senses. It means he has a first-hand knowledge about the fact which he is speaking. He has come to know about the things which he is speaking because of his own senses. That kind of evidence is called direct evidence. Let me share with you, Section 60 expressly says that all facts must be proved by way of direct evidence, not by any other mode of evidence. This is the fundamental principle under Indian Evidence Act. Though this general rule is the basic thing that we must adhere to, but there are certain exceptions are prescribed to this basic rule. And the person, though he does not have a first-hand knowledge about a particular fact, particular relevant fact, still he can depose about that fact, provided if he falls within particular categories. Those persons, even though he did not or she does not know about that fact personally, or he does not have a first-hand information about that fact, still under particular circumstances, he can talk about, speak about, and give evidence before court. That evidence is called indirect evidence. Thus, under Indian Evidence Act, we can see both direct evidence, indirect evidence. Though the fundamental rule is that only direct evidence is permitted and recorded, but under certain circumstances, exceptional situations, basing on sound policy considerations, even indirect evidence is also allowed. In the next slide, we will see under what circumstances indirect evidence is allowed. Now let us turn to the other mode of classification. The other mode of classification is oral and documentary. Oral evidence means a person testifies a fact with his own knowledge through his mouth before court of law is generally called as a oral evidence. If a person testifies a fact contained in a document by coming before the court, it is generally called a documentary evidence. It means whatever he speaks, his evidence is supported by a document, and that is also taken as a part of the record. That evidence which he is speaking with the aid of a document is called a documentary evidence. Thus, under law, we have fundamentally two classifications: oral evidence, documentary evidence, direct evidence, indirect evidence. Now let us see various indirect various situations under which indirect evidence is allowed. Number one, res gesta. Number two, admissions and confessions. Number three, statements made by those persons which are recognized are situations set out under Section 32 of Evidence Act. Number four, Section 33, it talks about statements made in a previous judicial proceedings. Number five, statements made in public documents. Number five, number six, opinion given by experts. In all these circumstances, six situations, all these persons, though they do not have a first-hand knowledge about the facts which they are speaking, but they have learned those facts which they are speaking before court through some other persons. Those persons who had a first-hand knowledge are through because of their eminence in particular field they are talking about. Law permits, even though it is a hearsay under certain circumstances. These are the six exceptional situations. Even though person does not have a first-hand knowledge, still he can give the indirect evidence, provided his facts are he is a person falling within the ambit of any of the six cases. Now coming to the documentary evidence, first understand what is meant by document. Document means any matter expressed or described on any substance. Any substance, it means it need not be a paper. It can be any substance, it can be wall, it can be human body or anything. If any letter, figure or mark is made, and that letter or figure or mark is made with an intention to communicate something or with an intention to record something, generally it is called as a document. Thus, to put it in one word, any substance which is used to communicate something or record something through words, letters, figures is generally called as a document. Under law, under Indian Evidence Act, we have variety of documents. They can be classified into primary and secondary, new and ancient, attested and non-attested, public and private, negotiable instrument and ordinary instrument, document with latent defects and patent defects. So, under Indian Evidence Act, there is a clear definition about what is document and what are various kinds of documents. These are the various kinds of documents which we see under Indian Evidence Act. There is a separate tutorial to explain about all these kinds of documents. Let me share with you, in the event of conflict between oral and documentary prevails. In the event of conflict between direct and indirect, direct will prevail. Thus, law gives superiority, primacy to the first-hand information or a more authenticated information. This is all fundamentally about evidence and kinds of evidence. That is the end of the class.